We help all children in the UK with any illness whatsoever. The only qualifying factor is they haven't been able to get the help elsewhere through the NHS or through other charities. So we are there to help all the most needy cases, kids with all sorts of illnesses, 600 illnesses in total. And in some of those cases, we're able to transform the lives completely. Kids with that have suffered various illnesses, we're able to get them walking again. With type 2 muscular atrophy, we provide them with a wheelchair, which doesn't get them walking, but gives them a life back. So there's so many different illnesses that we're helping with and helping to transform the lives and make the lives not only better for them, but for the parents and the siblings.
Why do you think there is such a gap between the need for support and the support that is being given by the NHS and by other government-led organisations?
Yeah, I mean, the gap between making all these kids' lives a lot better, it's a financial gap. And the NHS just can't afford. There's so many illnesses that the NHS have to fund. And when you look at some of the work we do, you'd have to say that in a Western civilization, these kids are entitled at the very, very least to what we do for them. But it's not available on the NHS because the NHS has no more money. You know, and the only way of providing this treatment for kids on the NHS would be to put people's taxation rate up to 60%, 70% and so on. And then, of course, that doesn't work for the economy of the country. So what we rely on as a nation, and so do many other nations, is the generosity of everybody in that country to donate money, and especially the wealthy who can really make a big difference. But it's down to everybody to do whatever they can do. But I think the wealthy really have a responsibility to do more. Well, it's very, very easy to find Caudwell Children on the website and to make donations. We love it when people get the heart and mind and not just the money, but that's not necessary. We need the money. We need money principally. But when people get the heart and mind into it, they really get a fantastic sense of spiritual reward for the work that they're doing. And they meet the kids and see the kids, those who they've provided a destination dreams holiday for, or who's been helped with autism, or who's been provided with a wheelchair that transforms their lives. So they can get very, very close to the work and to the children and see what difference their money makes. And that is a fantastic feeling.
I've been working with Caudwell Children for about 10, 15 years now, and it's second to none when it comes to the priority of the children and what the charity is for. John, who's obviously the CEO of the charity, and Trudy, who runs it as well, and Claire, everyone involved, they care about it. It's their charity, it's not just a charity, and that's what makes it so special.
You talk about why particularly helping families facing unique challenges like the ones that Caudwell Children address is so very necessary still.
Oh, goodness. I mean, you know, you only have to look around the world to see that so many children are in need. And what John and the guys at Caudwell Children do is raise money to help children in need for treatment and invest in them for their future when we can't get treatment for them on the NHS or elsewhere. You know, we've got the most amazing system in the world, NHS. I love it dearly, but not all treatments are available here in this country, and sometimes you've got to go further afield, and that takes a lot of money. I've got like loads and loads of Liberty X gigs coming up, so I've got about 30, 40 of those over the summer, so that's my main priority at the minute.
If fans are lucky enough to get a ticket for one of those Liberty X shows, what can they expect when they come and see you live over the summer?
Lots of flesh and I would say PVC, but it's more kind of plastic now.
You talk about the change in material. Can you talk about how you feel like the industry's changed since you guys started, obviously, because it's been a while since you guys were first out on stages?
Yeah, it's changed so much. I actually don't even know how it really works anymore. You know, like back in the day, there'd be 6 weeks of promo before you even release a single, and then when it goes in, that's the highest position. Now that you kind of climb to that position and it's all available online, I don't really understand it. I'm kind of glad I'm not around at the minute to release music, because it sounds really complicated.
I mean, obviously you've got all these great shows coming up over the summer. What's the future for you and the rest of the guys?
I don't think the future holds any new material. I just think that we love gigging, we love performing. You never know, maybe some kind of tour in the future. But for the minute, it's just kind of one-off gigs every weekend over the summer, and back to our, I suppose, normal life, if this is anything normal.
Why are nights like tonight and organisations like Caudwell Children so special and important?
I've met some of the families and the children, and they're absolutely brilliant. And everyone needs to be recognised and know what they're going through. People should know, and also that they need some help. And this is a fundraiser amongst fundraisers. And the good thing about it is that every penny goes to those children. So I think that a night like tonight could let other bigger organisations know that every penny goes to the charity, is used well, and is for a good cause.
You most looking forward to tonight? Obviously, amazing performances.
Well, I am performing this evening, but I do love Miss Alexander Burke. She's going to be here this evening. But I like everybody. Peter Andre and Ollie Mers is going to be there with a band, and I've never seen him perform live, so that'll be interesting.
When you're not performing here tonight, what else do you have coming up the rest of the year and beyond?
Well, I've just finished touring, and I've got lots of festivals, and then a little tour in Australia towards the end of the year. So it's busy and it's fun, and I'm writing, so all is well.
You're writing at the moment. What's inspiring that?
I think just life events, and the fact that I've come to a certain age, I'm still singing, and I love what I do. So it's just about life in general, my general thoughts, the philosophies for myself.
Oh my God, yes, it's a very incredible thing they do, and I'm very happy for them to having me here again this year. And definitely children are a category that needs to be support, and with the family, and the work they've been doing all year long is incredible, so I'm very happy to be here.
Of course, having been here before, can you talk a little bit about the atmosphere here tonight, what it's like to attend a butterfly ball?
Well, the atmosphere is incredible. There's such a nice vibe, such nice people, and it's nice to see so many people that are all united to support such a great cause. And of course, the whole evening, the whole night gets along very, very nicely. The auction, the ball, the dinner is a nice, is a very nice atmosphere. I really love it.
When you're not celebrating here tonight, what have you got coming up yourself work-wise at the moment?
Well, it's a moment where I've been put up for quite a lot of projects, so here is a moment of waiting for me work-wise, so I look forward to go to the next set soon.
What kind of stuff are you going out for at the moment mostly? Is it theatre, television, film?
Television at the moment, so, but of course I can't complain. It's a golden age of the telly at the moment, so there's some very great things going on the telly, so I'm very happy about that.
My final question, why do you think that is? Why do you think we have hit such a golden era for our small screen programming?
Well, because of course the quality has been improving a lot. A lot of actors that have been just being seen on the movies, on the feature film, has been swapping themselves, going to TV shows. The content is a lot. There's such great story being told through TV series. And of course the developing of channels like the ones that we used to watch the most, of course contributed about that. So ending up in a nice TV series is something for an actor that can make a nice ground credit on the resume, of course.
Events like this one for Caudwell Children are absolutely brilliant because obviously, they're raising much needed funds for families and children who without these kind of events just wouldn't get the same kind of support. And also it highlights what's happening and, where the needs are. So that's why I'm always very happy to support the Caudwell Children.
Do you think it's surprising that there is such a gap in need between what obviously families and people do need and what the NHS and the government is currently able to give them?
There's a huge gap in the need. And I think, obviously because there's a there's a finite source of cash, and it seems like there are more and more needs coming up, and we are just sort of seeing this kind of split. So a lot of families and a lot of children wouldn't get the support without the help of organisations like this. So yeah, it's really vital.
When you see and hear the amazing stories, the impact that this organisation's made on families' lives, are you good at keeping it together, or are there going to be some more to work?
you can't help but be moved by the stories that you hear and the situations. You know, it's sort of easy to forget because, of course, you know, here we are, we're at a fabulous event, we're all having a nice time. But it does sort of bring it home, and it brings back the reality of why these sorts of events are organised in the first place. And yes, it's incredibly moving. And sometimes you go away and it stays with you, which is why, you know, it's so nice. It's not much to support something like this. It doesn't take an awful lot. But, you know, every little bit helps, I guess.
Looking to the future, what have you got coming up yourself at the moment, apart from wonderful events like tonight? What else have you got on the go at the moment?
Really busy at the moment. I've just done a new show for ITV, so that's coming out shortly. Really looking forward to that. I can't say anything else about that. And, yeah, I'm training as a psychotherapist, so that's been wonderful. I'm 4 years in, another two to go. Yeah, so just keeping very busy and raising three teenagers.
Why are events like this so special and important?
Do you know what? I've been thinking lately that I really need to do, like, I want to get way more involved with charity stuff. I'm only 22, I'm not gonna lie. I'm still like learning all about different charities, and yeah, I just thought it's a great cause. So yeah, I'm really excited. I want to learn more and kind of get in with more charities.
When you hear stories about the amazing life-changing impact events like this and charities like this have had on young people's lives, are you quite good at keeping yourself composed, or is there going to be some water?
Oh no, I'm definitely gonna I feel like I'm gonna cry now. No, but yeah, definitely it's amazing. It's great.
And apart from getting more involved in charity, what does the rest of 2018 hold for you?
I'm not sure yet. Lots of exciting things. We've got lots of different things in the pipeline. I'm very excited.
I mean, you say different things, more television or more stuff offline?
Hopefully more television, yeah. And I'm doing a lot of modelling at the moment. All different bits, a lot of travelling. It's been great. I've had a good year so far, so fingers crossed it stays that way.
I think it's important for anybody who has a sort of profile to support charities that, you know, raise awareness and get other people involved, yeah.
When you're talking about charities like this that change the lives of young people in very difficult circumstance, is it hard for you to keep it together? Are there waterworks?
What do you mean, is it hard to... Oh, I see what you mean. Yeah. Getting emotional. Yeah. Yes, yes. But I don't want my makeup to run, so I've worn waterproof mascara tonight.
Glad to hear that. I think the last time we spoke, you were talking about a wonderful photo book that you'd been putting together. Can you give us any updates on that? When fans are going to get hold of a copy?
I will know exactly. It's not going to be till next year now, because they want it to be next year. So, but I was only in a big meeting about it today. It's all good.
In terms of, I mean, the last time we spoke, you talked a little bit about what fans can expect. Can you tell us a little bit more about the kinds of images you've been coming across when you trawl through that amazing archive that you have?
Yeah, I've got some really great images, some very funny ones as well, because Keith is actually a very funny guy. So I've got lots of... It's, you know, it's before the time of selfies. So, you know, the pictures... Nowadays, I think celebrities are very... on guard, but back then there were no selfies, so everything is very relaxed and normal, like home snaps. But it was, yeah, that's what it was then. So they're all very unguarded pictures and just like family. Yeah.
There are so many sort of myths and legends about that time, about those personalities. How many of them are true and how many of them have just grown over the years?
Oh, I don't know what they all are. I was in it, you see, so I don't know what they're saying. But mostly everything you think is true, and mostly worse.
Why do you think organisations like Caudwell Children are so special and important?
Literally, they completely and utterly change the lives of the children they support. I've been to charity events in aid of the charity before, and I've actually seen like young girls get up and speak about how things like chairs have completely and utterly changed their ability to live their life, to go to university, to just be like everyone else. And without charities like this, there wouldn't be that sort of support for people, so they're massive.
When you see that kind of beautiful, life-changing impact on children, Is it hard not to tear up? Do you manage to keep it together?
No, at things like this, I'm always the first one tearing up. It's hard not to. The stories are just absolutely, they're heartbreaking, but at the same time, they're inspiring. Like, it's usually tears, sort of, in a way that you're proud of the people and what they've achieved with what they, well, with the hand they got dealt.
Talking about strong emotional reactions, obviously the nation is already hooked, the new series at the moment. Have you been watching, and how are you feeling about all of the drama that's going on in there at the moment?
I've watched it every single night, and I love it. I love Love Island every year. It's going off a bit with Adam, Rosie, a couple's about to get dropped tonight, which is going to really cause a stir in the house. I just love it. I'm on the edge of my seat, and I'm starting to really fall for the characters.
In terms of those characters, who are you most hooked by? Who do you think's got the staying power to go all the way?
Jack and Danny, by far, are my favourite people in the villa. I don't think anyone comes close to them. Like, I think they're going to win. And do you know what? I think Laura's a really lovely girl. It's good to have a mature mind in there. And she's got such a good insight into all the problems in the villa.
I think, obviously, every year there's always a big debate about who's playing games, who isn't. Who do you think's playing games this season, and do you think that's even a problem, or is that just part of the show, that's part of the competition?
Adam's obviously playing games, but he's not very good at them. Eow, I think, like, just completely turns it on when he knows he needs to get onto a girl. And I think in a way it's part of the competition, but if you said you're there to find love, like, when production get people into the villa, they really want them to genuinely be finding love. So if you're going in there for a game, it's not really fair on the other contestants.
It is called Love Island. Do you think it's possible to find love in that public a space? Like, I mean, because not only when you're on the island, but when you come back home, it doesn't stop. People are still analysing every aspect of your relationship. I mean, I'd imagine that must be pretty tough, actually.
Yeah, it is. And I mean, my series ain't done a good job of it, have they? I mean, Camilla and Jamie, that's about all we've got. But when you look at the likes of Olivia Buckland and Alex and Cara and Nathan, it is well possible. And you've got to remember, these people are picked because realistically production think they're compatible in a way. So yeah, there's lots of chance to find love, I think.
Of course they're special. Anything for charity and things is definitely... Do you know what? We've got a group of celebrities coming. They should definitely do more stuff like this and, like, kind of put it out there and there to help other people. It's not all glamorous, everything. We're there to kind of do stuff like this, and I'm very honoured to be invited.
Does it affect you a lot emotionally when you see the amazing transformative effect organisations like this are able to have on families' lives?
Yeah, of course. Like, it's emotional, but I'm not gonna get... emotional. I'm going to here to support and kind of, like, enjoy it as much as possible, so without feeling sad. But I think it's a great cause.
Talking about happy things, you've got your product launch coming up soon. Can you tell us a little bit about what fans can expect when they get a hand on those new lip liners, those new products?
So obviously I'm launching my lipsticks and lip liners on the 1st July. From being from Essex, it works quite well, but it's a good product, so I kind of want to do as best I can with it, and I hope everyone enjoys it.
I mean, what's the difference for you between a good lippy and a bad lippy?
There isn't one, really. I think it's preference to what colours suit you and how to apply it. And I'm actually going to start blogging the makeup stuff now. So that's what I'm going to start doing on Instagram and my own YouTube channel. So it'll keep peeled, because I'm going to be doing some good stuff soon.
Apart from that, is there anything else you've got coming up? I think maybe some more TV work?
Yes, definitely. I can't say what yet, but there's good things coming. So I'm looking forward to the summer.
The rest of the nation's been hooked on Love Island at the moment. Have you fallen victim to it?
Yes, but I'm really disappointed. I want someone for Alex. I actually want someone for Alex this year. Like, do you know what it is? Us typical girls go for the same kind of guy, and I feel like he's a doctor. He reminds me of my brother, and I actually want to find a nice, decent girl that is this beautiful glamour model. I like her. She's my favourite, Megan. I really want her to go with him to change the typical girl that goes with a bad boy. I want him to go with a doctor.
Final question. Why do you think that is? Why do you think girls are always drawn to the bad
boy? I just feel like, do you know what it is? We like someone that plays it cool. We're weird humans. We like some act like we don't care, and I just think we like something that's a bit more edgy. So when they're too straight and narrow, it's a bit boring, but it's not a bad thing. I think we need to change that.
Fantastic to have you here with us tonight. Are you excited for the event?
Yeah, I'm really excited. Like, thank you so much to the Caudwell charity for inviting me tonight. I'm really excited. It's going to be a great night. I'm looking forward to the acts that are singing as well, so should be good.
It's a great night tonight, and it's for a very special cause. I'm curious, when you see the amazing impact that this charity has on young children's lives, Are you good at keeping it together, or do you think there might be some water work?
There's going to be tears. It's going to happen. I'm going to try and hold them back, but I do get quite emotional. So there'll probably be tears, but it's fine.
When you're not supporting this wonderful charity, what have you got coming up yourself at the moment, work-wise?
I've got a few collaborations with clothing brands and a few things I'm releasing, so you just have to keep your eyes out.